school. We have come to play. We've come to learn and remember forever and a day. Forever and a day.
Know that the maintenance rehearsal, the rote learning, is very shallow learning. And very soon, you've forgotten it.
Why then can I remember poems I learned at school?
Because you rehearsed them subsequently many times. When was the last time you quoted that poem?
Which poem?
Whichever poem you can remember.
Which one would you like?
Tell me one that you can't remember.
A short one.
Are there any poems you don't know? Are there any poems from school you can't remember?
I can remember
learning daffodils. I couldn't do it now.
I can.
Yes. So the question was, are there any poems that you know you can't remember?
There's some where I remember a little bit.
Okay. The ones that you can remember, you do not remember them from school. You remember them from the last time you practiced recording it.
Well, when we had the Kingston Festival of Speech and Drama, a group did The Highwayman,
yeah.
And I knew all of that because I did it at school.
When was the last...
You did it as a song.
When was the last time...
Yeah. No, that
was when you best the landlord's daughter in that.
No, no.
You shot herself.
No.
He's raising his eyebrows.
Come on. I'll have a makeup. I can remember lots of things, but I would say...
We're gonna space out our learning well to make it more rememberable. We're gonna space out our learning well to make it more rememberable. Because we have come to school. We have come to play. We've come to learn and remember forever and a day. Forever and a day. We're gonna draw, write and sing. We're gonna use interleaving. We're gonna draw, write and sing. We're gonna use interleaving. Because we have come to school. We have come to play. We've come to learn and remember forever and a day. Forever and a day.
The way memory works is you've got two things you need to do. One is to make it memorable, and the other is to practice recalling it. If you make it as memorable as you like, it can be amazingly a memorable story. If you never recall it, it will gradually become harder and harder to recall until it becomes almost impossible unless you get the right clue to fire up that recall. When people like yourself say, oh, I can remember that from school, you can't. All that's happened is you can remember it from the last time you remembered it. And each time you remember something, you modify your memories. It's quite strange. But most people think, oh yeah, I can remember that from school. No. We know scientifically that it's highly unlikely that you've remembered it directly from school, because if you have recalled it in the intervening period at all, you've changed your memory, and you haven't remembered it from the first time you learnt it.
We're gonna show our eyes where to look by pointing underneath the words in our book. We're gonna show our eyes where to look by pointing underneath the words in our book. Because we have come to school. We have come to play. We've come to learn and remember forever and a day.
To explain to other people, but the way I've looked at rote learning should not have the word learning attached to it. It's got no learning going on whatsoever. You've got some possible bits of information getting lodged into one localized bit of your memory, but it's not linked to anything else in your memory. So I would consider rote learning to never actually work. But even if you think it works, we know it's not very effective. And particularly for long-term recall, or even medium-term recall, or even short-term recall. So it's very short-term recall. It may work in very limited circumstances.
Can I just say, when I was at primary school, and this goes back a long time,
yeah.
We did all our maths by rote learning. We sat there and learned our time to say, well, rote learning. Repetition.
Yes.
We didn't have any understanding of what we were learning. But we learned it, and I can do my time and say it was backwards, forwards.
I go to the point I made earlier. You aren't doing that from the repetition you did at school. You're recalling it because you've rehearsed those facts subsequently.
It isn't common maths, for
instance, based on relationship. Yeah, I accept that, but where you're saying learning, there's a difference between learning and understanding.
Absolutely.
So, you can learn something in a rote fashion and not appreciate or understand at all.
So what is learning then?
Learning is taking information or data and turning it into knowledge and being able to use that experience in a different environment.
Ah, brilliant. So learning is understanding and being able to recall it sometime later.
Yes.
Brilliant. At the moment, in most of our educations, we are only teaching understanding. We don't teach how to recall it later. We just somehow assume that through the process of learning, somehow we're going to remember it.
Yeah.
And we know that's not to be the case. There are two things you need to do. One is understanding, the other is working on your recall. Yes.
We're gonna make our learning fun. The best way to get more learning done. We're gonna make our learning fun. The best way to get more learning done.
I saw on a website recently, a really good website, and it said to the kids, it's okay to make mistakes. Now that is wrong. It's not okay to make mistakes. It's absolutely vital. It's the only way to learn. And that's a little bit controversial.
The path to success is paid with failure.
There's so many comments like that, and everyone says it, but they don't put it into practice.
Because we have come to school. We have come to play. We've come to learn and remember forever and a day.
The weird one, interleaving, rather than block practice. Don't do an hour of the same subject, do 10 minutes of something, 10 minutes of something else, 10 minutes of something else, 10 minutes of something. It seems much harder for the students, and so they don't like it. But the effect is much more effective than trying to do block practice. If you want deep processing and understanding, you need to switch activities. There are two bits to learning.
Science and learning, SMI, learning SMI.